My question is both to Mr. Dutra and Mr. Henderson in regards to the oil project. The first part of the question is to Mr. Dutra. Knowing that the lease, section 6.1, said that your planning commission could not issue a CUP without the county releasing the open space from protected status, yet you went ahead and did that, and I want to know why. And to you, Mr. Henderson, based off the city's own records and emails, why did the city sign a secret agreement with the oil companies in February of 2008, 6 months, a letter of agreement, 6 months before the project went to bid?
So where's your name?
Roy.
Roy, what's your last name?
McKee.
Thanks, Roy. You know, Roy, if you attended the, I don't know how many planning commission meetings we had, I recall, and I know we had over 28 hours and several heated debates, if you will, planning commission. I think you saw that we also had legal counsel there consistently throughout the entire process. It's my assumption that the pretty good counsel that we had, they would have let us know if we were making a decision that was not legally supported. And so it was a tough decision. You know, I run those hills, still do. And I understand that the mitigations work. I also understand that we created some of the toughest, rigorous conditions on that project, of any project in Southern California. And I have friends of mine at the, several departments of oil and gas that told me that, in fact, we were creating some very, very secure conditions. So, given the fact that we had legal counsel listening to every word that we said, and I believe we had some of the best experts in Southern California, if not the nation, I think we made the right decision.
Was to a secret agreement with the oil company 6 months before we went to bid. We did talk points early on to try to understand what was perhaps possible with an oil lease. We hired Jim Day, who is one of the two leading professional attorneys on oil in California. Between the two offices, they do about that. Somewhere between 93 and 96% of all oil leases in the state. Jim was very clear that California code requires a specific bid process. We adhered to that process. We went to bid under the way it had to be done. We notified every major oil company in California, and we proceeded under code. You are one of these people who likes to come up with things that he thinks he read 5 or 6 years ago and thinks there's a evil interpretation of Mr. Key. And I've said to you many times in counsel, if you think there's anything illegal or anything that was done, go to the district attorney.
We will. Not a problem.
And if you really feel it, go and file a complaint. The business about this business, I know you like to film things. I'm sure you go back and watch this film dozens of times and try to find secret meetings. And I know that you have applied for thousands of documents from the city of Whittier. You've wasted a tremendous amount of time in the city clerk's office, put the city in a great, unfortunate situation, met people in working weekends and so on. I really object when you take little people like this and just because of some thing that you are obsessed by, and yet you generated nothing, absolutely nothing. You were head of the Whittier Oil Watch, and your organization sued the city, and way before the EIR was even finished, you abandoned that lawsuit.
No, that wasn't us. Let's get that clear, Mr. Henderson.
We're going to move on to the next question. I think Mr. Henderson's established that he disagrees with your portrayal of
that was an organization.
Okay. Uh,